In SR latch with enable input, the input combination 1-1 for S and R is forbidden. Okay, but we cannot expect the user to be well behaved. If we say this input should not be supplied, the mischievous users may intentionally supply 1 and 1, okay, which will put the circuit in an indeterminate state. To avoid this, we are going for a D-latch. What are the input combinations that are useful to us? When S is 0, we are going to reset the circuit with S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1. When S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, we are going to set the state of the circuit. When it is 0 and 0, it is going to retain the information. Even if this input is not going to be 0 and 0, if we remove the enable input, then also we can retain the information. So using this, we can construct the D-latch. So here there is only one input, D, but the remaining circuit is the same. Instead of S and R, we have D input and the complement of D is going to be supplied here. Because the useful inputs are going to be 0, 1 and 1, 0. So instead of supplying two inputs, I get one input D and the complement of D will be supplied to the other gate. Now when D is set to 1, Q will be set to 1 because this gate is going to get a 0 input. So it is like set and reset here. So when D is set to 1, Q will be set to 1 and Q bar will become 0 when enable is 1. And similarly, when D becomes 0, Q becomes 0. Let's try to work out that when enable is 0, you can see that irrespective of this D input, the output here is going to be 1 and 1. When these two outputs are 1, this cross-coupled NAND gate SR latch is going to retain the information. So there will not be any change in the state of the circuit. That means that it is no change. When enable becomes 1 and D is 1, so you have 1 here, you have 1 here. So 1 and 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0. And here 1 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1. And suppose if I have 1 here and therefore 0 here, 0 and 0 is 0 and not of 0 is going to be 1. 1 and 1 is going to be 1 and not of 1 is going to be 0. Okay, and you can see that when D is 1, the circuit is set. Now when D becomes 0, this becomes D bar will become 1. So in this case, 0 and 1 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1. And here it is 1 and 1, therefore this is going to become 0. So 1 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1, that is supplied here. 1 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1, that 1 will be supplied here. 1 and 1 is 1, not of 1 is 0, and this 0 will come here. 0 and 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1, and therefore the output has stabilized and we can see that the circuit is now reset because the input D is 0. So when enable is 1, when you supply D as 0, the circuit will be reset. When D is 1, the circuit will be set. This is the operation of the D latch. Now let's see the graphical symbols of different latches that we have seen. for an SR latch, this is the symbol, this is the S input, this is R input, this is Q and this is Q bar, the output. And this is active low input SR latch. That is why we have a bubble in the input. So this is like NOR, cross coupled NOR implementation of the SR latch. This is cross coupled NAND implementation of SR latch. And this is the D latch with the enable input. So this is the input, this is the enable, this is Q and this is Q bar.